What about if we shoot an item? Let's suck the item into it. Just knocks out. Oh, it did suck that fish in. Did y'all see that? Hello, everyone. This is Nick with CoopCritics.com, and welcome back to another Subnautica gameplay video. When we last left off, we found the moon pool. Woohoo! Finally, we got it. And we installed the modification station for the Seamoth. We still haven't named it, but I think I want to name it Seamoth, because like it's totally a she. Like, listen, when you get in it.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Welcome aboard, Captain. That's totally a woman. Oh, come on, pick me back up. There we go. All right. And I went ahead and made a couple of things and already installed them. You can see 3 out of 4 already installed. So let's look at the upgrades. We've got a pressure compensator. This hardens the vehicle chassis under high pressures. Then we have a Seamoth torpedo system, which I am excited to try out. And then hull reinforcement hardens the chassis before collision, eliminating damage under normal conditions. So that will help it stay, keep us from taking on as much damage when we have collisions and stuff. This will help us go dive deeper, and this will give us a little bit of defense. I wonder if we can equip more than one of these to go down even further. Let's see what a pressure compensator, plasteel ingot. So real quick, I'm gonna go back over to the base, or we're in the base, but I'm gonna go back over to our inventory. Look how many jelly rays we have. They are just like mating like crazy right now. All right, so we're gonna head over here. We've got all these plants, and the only thing we ever eat is the lantern fruit. It's kind of OP, but that's okay. I don't mind. Plasteel ingot, that's what I need. Do I have a plasteel ingot stored anywhere? Sometimes I like have random plasteel ingots. Yes. I do have one randomly stored. I do have a computer chip because I went ahead and made a bunch of computer chips for when I was making the other stuff. The other, like almost all the mods require computer chips, and so I made like 3 or 4. All right, pressure compensator. Let's make that bad boy, and then we'll take it over here. Let's see if we can add more than one. Oh no. Hey, she didn't say welcome aboard, Captain. I'm disappointed in you, Seamoth. Okay. Maybe she doesn't like her name very much. I can understand. All right. Access upgrades. Pressure compensator. Yes. So that may be worth making a third one and getting rid of that, because I don't know how much that's actually going to help us, because we don't really take on that much hull damage. Of course, we haven't really encountered anything that can do a lot of damage to us yet. So now we can go... Wait. 300 meters, it said. Let's see what it says if we remove one of these, because I thought 300 meters was what we could already do. Sorry, we're doing a little bit of testing here. So it doesn't give us any extra. So 300 meters is the maximum we can do, it looks like, no matter what, until we get a better... I think you can unlock a different kind of like hull reinforcement. I may be making that up. I thought there was another kind. That's kind of a bummer that... I guess we'll just stick it in there for now, but... All right, whatever. So we're going to take this sucker out and we're going to test some of the things. We've got torpedoes. And there we got them equipped. And there's 2 different types of torpedoes. There's the vortex torpedo, which is what we have, which is just the standard one. And there's the gas torpedo, which we have to collect those little gas pods from the like fart whales or whatever they are. The guys that pop those green bubbles out at us. So we may go collect some of those so that we can make the other kinds of torpedoes as well. There's a guy right there. So let's see if we get close. The problem is you have to grab the you have to grab them before they explode or they hurt you. What? Why didn't I? I couldn't grab any of them? Okay, something's not right. I used to be able to grab them. Squirt me with a bubble. Come on, bubble butt. Come on, Mr. Fartwell. There we go. I got two. No. Okay, that hurts. Backing up. How did my health go up immediately after that? Did you see that? You are ugly. What? I swam right through it. I can't grab it. So it only hurts for a minute and then our health goes right back up. That's kind of weird. Maybe I need to put this up. So we'll just swim. Okay. What? Apparently he pooted on me and I didn't realize it. All right. We're going to get some of these, dang it. How many do we have? Four. Oh, come here. No. Oh. Okay, they're not actually like permanently hurting me. They're just temporarily hurting me. Okay. See, my health keeps going straight back up. That's weird. I guess it's only... Unless they did an update where you regain health really quickly. That's very strange. All right, so let's head back over here. Let's try to make some of these torpedoes real quick.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
Welcome aboard, Captain. Okay. Yeah, we're going to need titanium. There we go. Titanium times two. Gas pod. So we'll only be able to make... And each one of those makes three torpedoes. So we need four titanium. You know what? It may be faster to get to the front of the building over here by just doing this. I think it is. It's much faster than going all the way through. Do we even have any titanium? That's the wrong case there. We have one titanium left after this. So that's crazy. But yeah, I think this is totally quicker just to go this way. I'm going to have to make an alternate route to some of these things. So we're not taking the long route all the way through every time. All right. So now we're going to make some gas torpedoes. So it gives us three torpedoes for every time that we make it. And see, I ran out of room. So I actually don't have enough room to store all these. I'm missing one. Let's see. And this is kind of weird too. Like I don't understand why, but you actually have to get in the Seamoth, like bring it down into the water, get out of the Seamoth, swim around to the front to your little torpedo bay thing here, and then you can put in some torpedoes. So Seamoth vortex torpedo. So if we, what if we, oh, we can't. Let's shoot a couple of these and then we'll have the other ones in our inventory to replace them. So let's go find something to shoot. We're not going to kill it. I had some people get really upset because I killed a bird a couple of episodes ago. And so I'm not going to kill it. Promise, guys. You don't have to call PETA on me. I just don't know what to do in some of these games. Sometimes I feel like, okay, maybe I should kill this because it'll give me something, and then it doesn't. And that doesn't mean I enjoy killing things. It just means I'm playing a video game. Oh, I don't know why I'm trying to grab that. I can't actually get it. I was trying to grab that because I'm low on titanium. We'll have to actually go farm some titanium at some point. There's a bunch of it over here. Right now, I just want something to shoot. I could just shoot a fish. I was wanting something like a bad guy, maybe. Like a stalker or something, maybe. Oh. I mean, there's a stalker over here? No? Let's just try it and see what happens. That's not it. Here we go.
Phew.
That's kind of neat. Is it actually... So it I came out of the water. That was cool. Let's keep going. Let's see. There's got to be a stalker or something over here, right? For us to shoot. See if a fish is close enough to it. That's not going to be close to that fish at all. What about if we shoot an item? Will it suck the item into it? It knocks out. Oh, it did suck that fish in. Did y'all see that? Let's see if the fish is okay. Well, he's gone. So we either got transported to another dimension or he's dead. Let's replace some of these now that we've shot them with... No. See, this is... I wish... There's got to be... There needs to be a way to access this from inside. There we go. So we've got one more vortex torpedo.
Welcome aboard, Captain.
And then more... other ones. I wonder if I could add another torpedo bay to this. I bet I could. We should go back to the base and try... Oh my gosh, I always run into these fish. Okay, we should go back and try that. Because maybe if I add another torpedo bay, I can add it to the other side, and that way I can select between regular vortex torpedoes or gas torpedoes while I'm out here. That would be pretty cool. I really don't understand why the pressure compensators don't stack. That's kind of a bummer. It doesn't really make sense to me. You'd think they would, but oh well. All right, so let's hop up in here. We're going to have to eat something too. What do we need to make the torpedo? Magnetite and computer chip. We need another computer chip. I think we have silver. No. Let's go this way. I need to make a different path for sure. For sure I do. Computer chip, what do we need? I think it's silver and table coral. That's the wrong thing. All those are wrong. Table coral, silver, ore, and quartz. We have one quartz, which is exactly what we need, I think. Silver. One silver. And we need two table coral. We have plenty of table coral. All right. Computer chip. Now we need magnetite. I know we got magnetite in here. Yeah, we got plenty of magnetite. That magnetite, yo. That was a really stupid joke. I'm sorry. I'll never do it again. Okay. Whoa, just launched myself out of there. Let's make one of these. We need to get some storage chests in here too, but for that we're going to need some titanium and quartz, because we need to make some storage lockers like all along this wall so we're not running back and forth all the time. All right, so let's remove one of these pressure compensators since it's not actually doing anything for us, and let's do it like that. No, that's wrong. This. Okay, so now let's hop out and let's look. Yes, that is exactly what I wanted to have happen. That's wrong. And then the rest of these will go over here. And that'll be fine. So this one, it has one gas, but the rest are vortex. And that one's all gas. We have an extra gas pod there. Cool. All right. So, okay, I guess I'm going up. Didn't mean to do that. But there is one more thing I wanted to look at. And it is back at the entrance over here. I wanted to look at the modification station right here, because I think that there is another thing that we can make for the Seamoth upgrade. There we go. Pressure compensator Mark II. Computer chip plasteel ingot 2. Wow. Aluminum oxide crystal. And then Mark 3. So we should totally do this. I think this is what we're going to do this episode. We're going to take the we'll take the Seamoth out. We'll get rid of the torpedoes in our inventory, and we're just going to collect a lot of titanium because we're going to need a lot to make two plasteel ingots. We've got plenty of aluminum oxide, and we'll need some more silver. But I definitely want to do that because that's how we're going to update the depth for the Seamoth. And I want the Seamoth to be able to go much deeper than 300 meters. It's just not enough. This is like a little mushroom biome thing over here, though. We can check it out. This one's different than the other one that we were going to. It's in a different part. All these mushroom trees. This is where I got the jelly ray eggs. Well, not this one, but the other mushroom biome is where I got the jelly ray eggs. Okay, there's a whole bunch of things to scan right here, so I'm going to hop out and scan them. Because I feel like... Scanner room, yes, this is something I need. I don't completely have the scanner room yet. I have a couple of fragments for it, but maybe we'll complete it right here. One. Yep, this'll do it. So I don't know what the scanner room is for. Oh yeah, we also have the nuclear reactor that I was going to build this episode, and I haven't built it yet either. All right, so let's head over here because there should be some items over here. Here we go. Here's some scrap metal. Let's just swim around this area for a little bit. Get some quartz. We'll open up one of these cases. What are you? That's just a med kit. Not that important. This probably has a cat in it. It looks like it has a cat in it. Pick up signal. What signal was it? Geological formation. I already have that, so I'm gonna drop it. Any more scrap metal just laying around? Moon pool. Really? There's moon pool fragments over here. I'm getting titanium, so that's good. What are you gonna be? Moon pool? You gotta be kidding me with this moon pool stuff, man. I've been looking for you forever. Now I find you like in back-to-back episodes in different places. Okay. There's some scrap right there. I don't know that I can pick it up, though. Let's see how much room we have. We need to get rid of this torpedo. We can drink that water. I dropped it. It hurt me. That was dumb. I didn't know it was going to hurt me. Okay, it's still hurting me. Wow. Okay, yeah. Word of the wise, don't drop those. That was ridiculous. Okay. Is my health going to go all the way back up? And I'm low on food. Okay, I'm going to have to kill a fish real quick. Oh my gosh, I'm swimming so slow. This is the slowest I've ever swam. Come here. I promise I'm not going to hurt you with my thermal knife. I just need to cook you. There we go. Okay. That's better. I need some more fish that I can cook and eat. Come here, please. All you weird things. Okay. There we go. All right, needed to eat. All right, we're gonna have to head back and then we'll come back out here and look around for some more scrap metal. All right, guys, we went back. We turned all of our scrap into titanium and now we're back out wanting to collect some more scrap because we need more. We had enough to make one plasteel ingot. We need two plasteel ingots, so we need some more titanium. What is this? That's weird. And we also need some silver. These are limestone, so they're not going to have silver in them, but we will need to stop over in the in our little silver area, or our area where we normally get silver, which is in the creep vine weeds and stuff over there. You can usually find some silver in that area, so we'll go over there in just a second. Right now I just want to pick up as much scrap as I can. We might can pick up one more. No, it's full. Let's see if it's actually full. Yeah, we're going to need to save that last spot for a piece of silver. So we'll head back to the Seamoth and go back into the creep vine and see if we can get ourselves some silver, because we're going to need to make a computer chip. And then we'll be ready. We'll be ready to do our little upgrade. And then maybe we'll have enough time in this episode to make the, what is it called? Nuclear reactor. So I'll be right back. All right, guys. We finally got all the tools or parts and pieces that we needed. Now we're going to upgrade this sucker to Mark II. I don't know what it's going to give us. It was 300. So we're going to need to replace this. Because we made two of them, so we just upgraded one of them. So we're going to need to replace it. Let's grab some food while we're on our way upstairs, because we're hungry. Still got that stupid torpedo on us we need to get rid of. And this is turning out to be a pretty good farm for our bioreactor, because I can pick these things up. And so they're reproducing really fast, and they last a long time in the bioreactor. And so that's turning out to be pretty good. All right, so what? Let's get rid of this. Or no. Ooh. Okay, let's do that one. Crush depth now 500 meters. Mark II. Yeah, so we're not going to be able to stack them, even if it is a Mark II and a Mark I, I guess. So now our crush depth is 500 meters. So that adds an extra 200 meters on there, which is awesome. We'll put that in there. Yeah, and so if you didn't notice, I made a couple of lockers right here just so we could store some things that we're needing a lot for right here, like mostly titanium and not quartz, but probably titanium and some of those gas pods and stuff so that we can make more torpedoes. But the next thing I want to look at doing is actually building that reactor. So let's see what we need for that. Nuclear reactor, where are you? Titanium ingot 2, 3 lead, and more lubricant. Ooh, yikes. Okay, so we've got lead and we can get lubricant easy, but like we just went out and tried to find a whole bunch more titanium. And we would need enough titanium to not only make two ingots, but also build a new area. We'll have to build another one of these rooms. I don't think we have enough titanium on us right now. I don't think we have any titanium on us right now that I'm thinking about it. Oh, scanner room too. Man, we got so many new things that we got to try out. So I would need 6 for this. Where would I want to put it? Probably put it right there. I don't know, though. If I put it there, I can't stack anything on top of it, because then it would get in the way, right? If I put 2... maybe not. No, I can still get it in and out. Let's see if we put 3. That totally works, strangely enough. Okay. Yeah, we'll build it right here, because... it's not going to be in the way of us bringing the Seamoth in and out. And then we'll probably go ahead and put another... and we're out of battery on this. So let's grab this one. And... reload this sucker. 100% battery. We'll put this 0% battery back in there. Like a so. And what do we need? Lead... titanium ingots. How much titanium do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We have 6 titanium. That'll be enough to actually build this. And then we can go find some more. Obviously, it will be off camera because this episode will already be going a little long. What am I doing? Not that. There we go. So now that'll come right out of this aquarium room, and then we'll put the nuclear reactor in there, and then we might can build the scanner room above that. But right now I want to focus on the nuclear reactor. So again, let's look and see what we need. 2 titanium ingots, so that is 20 titanium, so that is 5 five of the actual scrap metal pieces, and then three lead. We have plenty of lead and lubricant. So I'll be right back when I get all those supplies, and we'll build the radioactive whatever. No. Nuclear reactor. That's it. Be right back. All right, everybody. I got all the supplies that we need. I'm about to build this sucker in our new multi-purpose room that we just built. Did it. Now we have to put in these reactor rods that take uranium, lead, and titanium to make one. So they're not super expensive, but I mean, you got to have plenty of uraninite. But look at this. We had 700 power and now we have 1200. So it adds a full 500 power to our little base here. So that's pretty awesome. And then we'll just have to wait and see kind of how long this actually lasts, how long each of these rods lasts. If it lasts a really long time, then that's great. That means this will probably be our primary source of power. We'll still use the bioreactor just because it's efficient, or I say efficient, it's really simple to use because we have so many items that we can put in there. You know, we can put animals, we can put plants, we can put seeds, whatever. But the nuclear reactor will be kind of the new hotness right now. So I'm kind of excited about that. I haven't even visited my old Reginald tank in a while. I haven't really needed to. I've been eating not Reginalds. I've been eating fruit. Need to get some meat in me. Oh, I forget that it makes your water go down when you eat uncooked Reginalds. Dang it. Okay. Well, that's going to do it for this episode, guys. It probably went a little long. It's hard for me to keep up with it when I'm jumping around a whole lot. But we got a lot accomplished. We upgraded our Seamoth. We upgraded our Seamoth. We built the nuclear reactor. We got torpedoes. We got two torpedoes right there. That's pretty great. We did a little bit of exploring. Not a ton of exploring, but just kind of enough to get titanium, essentially. So this is a fun episode. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe, and I will see you next time as I jump right through the Seamoth. Bye. Please be Moonpool. Yes. Oh my gosh. We're hitting the jackpot right now. Okay, we need two more for Moonpool. Those things are insane looking. Let's go back up to the Seamoth while we can. Oh, wait.